So lay down, the pain is real. When his sight goes red again.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you all been waiting for. Live from the DoubleTree Hotel here in Oakbrook, Illinois, it's time for your Cutthroat MMA main event of the evening. 3 rounds in the heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man stands in at 6 feet even, official weight, 258 pounds. Undefeated as a mixed martial artist, he has a record of 1 win against no defeats. Representing the Bag MMA, and joining us tonight from
the DoubleTree in Oak Brook. As we are underway, a lot of excitement. Samie Sabbah has the crowd in his corner.
Ray, we have some big boys in this cage right now. They're gonna be swinging heavy leather.
You know, Samie Sabbah told me earlier today that he believes he is 20 years of age, that speed, that his athleticism is gonna play a factor in the fight. Pete Becker is a 9-time All-American, was a member of the United States World Wrestling Team. So his wrestling pedigree is world-class, is Pete Becker.
Yeah, Sabah's going to want to stand in this fight. Becker right for a takedown. We're going to see if he can get him down, though.
Going for a takedown is Pete Becker. Becker looking for that single leg. You know, Samie Sabbah, 20 years of age, he's a construction worker by day, wrestling and football coach and fighter by night at Bolingbrook High School. You know, he wrestled at Bolingbrook High School and was ranked in the top 3 in the state. But there's one thing about wrestling at that level, Matt, and then there's another thing about wrestling for Team USA.
Yeah, it's a big difference. But you know what, though? It levels out when you can tell how well people develop wrestling for MMA. That's another thing, though. It looks like he's struggling with this takedown.
Right now, Pete Becker looking to hold on to that single leg. And they bounce around. And Sabbah avoids the takedown. What courage And what athleticism by Samie Sabbah.
Yeah, this is where Sabbah definitely wants to be. Exchanging punches. I wouldn't go for too many kicks.
Sabbah coming nice out of the camp cross with Chris Sizemore in the pack of MMA. And a nice right hand that lands for Sabbah. Sabbah getting the better of the strike, and he looks very mobile and agile on his feet.
Yeah, he moves really well for a heavyweight. We're going to see if Becker shoots again. I really think he's going to. He got clipped a couple times.
I would be surprised. And, oh, that was a roundhouse kick and a head kick that had dangerous and bad intentions written all over it. Becker, like a bear, moves him against the cage.
He missed that kick, but he landed a punch right after, though. Sabbah wants to try to break him off here. He's catching his breath. I don't know how well both of these fighters' cardio is.
But Becker's got him real deep right now, man. You know this, on the shoot, he's got him real deep. And when Pete Becker gets you that deep, wrestling-wise, he takes you down. And Sabbah, for a brief moment, held onto the cage. But Becker's still unable to get Sabbah down.
No. Looks like he's trying for a switch there. He's going to want to try to, especially right here, work a wizard there. Looks like he's working for a choke. I don't think he's going to get it.
And that ends round one. That, the sprawl of Samie Sabbah is huge. Becker knows he's got to dig down deep and win these next two rounds. Sabbah, at least on my scorecard, has one in the books.
Yeah, I would agree with that. He was able to defend all the takedowns and land some really big punches.
Nice front kick that lands for Sabbah. Sabbah comes in and he kind of got him to the groin area. They touch gloves, a nice show of sportsmanship between Becker and Sabbah. And Sabbah again, a nice right hand. Sabah's doing a nice job of darting in and out, and a nice head kick. Becker going for that takedown, but it is Sabbah who's more athletic and agile, and has got Becker guessing.
Sabah's going to want to move away here. He's trapped against the fence right now, but he as we saw in the first round, he shows he could have takedown defense. If he could defend this takedown, I would take the center of the cage.
And the chants of Samie are being echoed here at the capacity crowd, the jam-packed DoubleTree here in Oak Brook, Illinois. We thank all of you for joining us here on CultureMMA.com. I am still very impressed and just amazed by the takedown defense that Samie Sabbah has, and now Becker looking to finish that takedown, but Sabbah again keeps himself upright and a knee to the kidney area of Pete Becker.
Now right here, with them clinched like that, Becker still has a possible takedown there. I would separate a lot more if I were Sabbah. If I were Becker, I would actually try to look for body lock.
There goes Becker, Sabbah looking to finish Becker! He taps and this one's over! Samie Sabbah! Was the underdog coming into the fight. And lo and behold, Samie Sabbah defies the odds. And
gentlemen, the end comes at 1 minute 31 seconds of the second round for your winner by way of tap out due to strikes and still undefeated, Samie Swapping Sabbah.
Any special training you did for this fight to prepare?
Not really, just normal cardio stuff. I was out of town for a couple of weeks prior to the fight up in Canada, so I kind of cut into that. I would have liked to have done more, obviously. It didn't go exactly the way I wanted it to. And by the end of the first round, I was pretty spent, which is kind of pathetic. Yeah, I need to get my cardio better and, my striking defense. Second round, once I got tired, I was having a hard time keeping his punches off of me.
I knew Pete was a really good wrestler. I knew he was a pretty good wrestler, and I knew he was pretty old, so I knew my athleticism, speed would play a factor. I was a little worried when he got me against the cage the first time. I know that's a specialty. So when I had that stuff, I knew I had it. No problem.